I'm your trustee board president, and I have with me tonight some very special guests who came all the way in from the Bay Area. Let's give it up for Shirklop Pons! So tonight our esteemed guests, Griffin Lewis and Jenny Nicholson, have for us a very special treat to watch, so I'm going to let them explain all about it.
This is a little short. I think the program says that we're showing an episode. I apologize for that. This is only a short. There's some miscommunication going on. But yeah, this is an exclusive Everfree Northwest release. And the circumstances in which we made this was very unfortunate. And as a result, we had to move everything from a hard drive from where I live back to our Karen's house and try to render the video. But lots of files got lost and misplaced, and we ended up having to re-edit it. So it's a little rough, and I apologize for that. But yeah, here it is anyway.
I'm so excited for my 8th bi-weekly Moon Princess Festival. Tonight, I thought I'd wow them with another puppet show.
Or you could raise the moon. When you're doing a puppet show, you can only force your friends and neighbors to watch. But every pony can see the moon.
Good thinking. I'm so smart. Keep up the great work, Twilight.
Right. I brought lots of fruits and vegetables so you can stay healthy. We wouldn't want you to get fatigued.
Wow, Twilight. I wish I had a reptile pet that was as slow and dumb looking as yours.
Me? I'll wear whatever costume I need to, big sister.
My apple just talked, but I don't regret eating it. Twilight, will tonight bring the exciting conclusion to your puppet saga?
I sure hope so.
Oh, Spike, I thought you'd look great in this super emasculating bow tie.
Hot ziggity! I'm finally beautiful on the outside. Now I'm worthy of love.
Pinky, slap him.
Look, everypony, up in the stars.
To disappoint.
And now Spike has been punched!
Red alert! Red alert! Rain Cloud, come in, Rain Cloud! We need your help! Where are you?
Goes the other way.
We're going to give our talk from behind this screen now. No. Okay.
It's more mysterious.
Goes in general Colts, short pop bones.
Thank you. Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Well, short pop bones. Okay, really quick before we start, I just wanted to pass on to you guys from the hotel that for those of you standing up in the back, we do have some seats that have not been filled yet. The hotel has asked that you please fill in the seats or Please vacate, because this room does have a fire marshal capacity, and we just want to make sure that everybody stays safe and, you know, at least finds a seat. We do have, like I said, we have plenty of seats dotted throughout the crowd, and we actually have a few here. So please just go ahead and spread out a bit. Thank you.
There's one in the front, next to that guy.
Can all the little kids come to the front, please? Yeah.
So we're going to go ahead and just start with just a general panel for both Griffin and Jenny. And we're going to have Q&A toward the end of the panel. So anypony who wants to talk to Griffin and Jenny or ask them, or perhaps a special guest who has not been named yet, a question, please line up in front of a microphone in an early, orderly fashion behind the projector.
All right.
Okay, so wonderful. I'm Jenny. I do the writing, and I voice the main six and Apple Bloom and Spike.
All right, and I'm Griffin, and I also do the writing and the editing and the music. So, yay.
Yay.
this is it. This is the whole thing.
So I guess the first question that comes not only from me but from several people is why witchcraft? Why friendship is witchcraft, besides just the subplot with Pinky?
I think we just thought it was the funniest synonym for magic. It's just so inherently wrong for a kids' show to have witchcraft in the title. But it still almost works, which is kind of on level with a lot of our jokes, where it would almost work for a kids' show, but there's just something a little off and scary. Yeah.
Pretty much that. It's just funny sounding.
Yeah.
It's because
it's not much really to the title.
So... Yeah. How long have you guys known each other?
Six, seven years, high school.
We are just in drama class and various classes, and that's it.
Yeah.
So I think that I speak not only for myself, but plenty of other ponies when I am curious. Do you do voice acting professionally?
No. This is my first time voice acting for anything. That's why it's so like rough in the first episode, and in my opinion, it gets better as I go.
So what do you guys, you know, when you say it gets better, do you guys generally have a method that you use to try and, you know, to refine your skills? Because it's very obvious as you watch the progression of witchcraft that just it gets more and more refined. The characters kind of come more into their own as far as the voices and the delivery.
Yeah, I think it's just the result of practice, like, you know, a lot of practice doing the episodes. And we got a better mic around episode 3, which I think a lot of people noticed.
Yeah.
Can you think of anything?
And, in terms of improving over time, I mean, it's sort of subjective, really. Like, definitely each episode, I think, stands alone in a way, which is something we wanted to do. Like, some episodes, you know, like episode 3 is sort of a lot of, like, just random non sequiturs, and it's kind of like silly, and they go on adventures and stuff. And then an episode like episode 2 is all about like subverting the plot and trying to change the original meaning of the episode to be something totally different, right? And so we just, you know, we do an approach, you know, and like the Sweetie Belle one was like our heartfelt episode, and, you know,
yeah.
And we jump all around. And so as a result, I think people almost, like, they're inclined to pick and choose favorite episodes, which I think is really strange.
Yeah, and people tend to have different ones they think are the bad episodes, too.
Yeah.
And it's never consistent, so we aren't really sure
really
if there
weird,
are
yeah.
bad episodes.
We get strange feedback and stuff. We always go like, oh, I really like...
Because it
liked,
could be someone else's favorite.
I really liked how
you
wrote
know?
It in an episode, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, can't you do that again? And it's like, you know, we just always do jokes that we find to be, like, funny to ourselves. So,
Well, it really does seem obvious that the heart of the humor in Friendship is Witchcraft is in the writing itself. And, you know, tell us a little bit more about the process. Is this a truly collaborative process between the two of you guys?
Yeah. We make a shared Google Doc, and we find online the transcript for the original episode, and then we italicize all those lines and just type in next to them whatever lines we think of. So, like, the jokes we just that come to us and feel really strongly funny to us go in first, and then we fill in all the gaps around it, try to have a consistent story going.
Yeah, basically some jokes jump right away, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what we wanted. Like, what's a good example?
Like episode 3, when Applejack says, like, everyone has some aspect to their personality, and Rainbow
Dash
is like, I
right.
don't.
So that's like,
so that was like,
the,
right
that was
away.
Like the first joke
yeah.
we wrote, and then a lot of times it's like the first, like, 50% of the script is written in, like, you know, an hour, because you're just going through and you're reading the original lines, and you're kind of thinking of, like, funny ways to subvert that.
Mm-hmm.
And then as you're at that point, you sort of the episode is... Sort of, you can sort of see the whole piece that's coming together. Mm-hmm. And then it gets really hard because then you've got like two lines left. They have to be, you know, 10 syllables and then 8 syllables, and they have to like get the audience to this point in the narrative, and you have to rewrite a bunch of lines. So really, yeah. It's like, at first it's really easy and fun, and then it's like those last 10 lines are like, oh no.
We have
like,
no ideas for
it these. Doesn't make, yeah. Like, we didn't, you know, you can't get from this dialogue to this dialogue in these two lines, and it's sort of challenging.
Mm-hmm. By the way, I just want to just make everyone clear. If you want to do Q&A, we actually are starting to line up for that at any time you
questions.
Would like to.
I think we'll do more. We're going to do more Q&A than anything else, right?
Yeah, we're going to be doing that. Yeah, for the most of the panel. And so anybody wants to talk in the Q&A, please feel free to line up in an orderly fashion in the middle of the room.
Yep.
I think one of the things that I was going to ask is one of the things that sets Friendship is Witchcraft apart more than anything else is the fact that it's so musical and it's so, you know, it's so seamlessly musical. How much of the music is a joint process and how much of it is just kind of something that is written independently?
Sort of the process is you watch the episode and you look at the part, it's supposed to be a musical segment, whatever it is, and then I will basically do a really rough cut of it. And I'll send it over to Jenny, and we'll try to maybe change the key of the song so she can, sing in whatever character voice she's doing. And then, like the writing, there's a shared Google Doc.
And we just do the lyrics.
We just do the lyrics the same manner where, you think of lyrics. And a lot of times, when I'm writing the song, the melodies, I don't really know what the song is going to, what the actual lyrics are going to be, just the melody. But there'll be like one or two phrases, like,
Yeah, usually the chorus.
In Pinky's Brew, it was, watch as I work my gypsy magic. And after that, it's like, na 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 na. And then, Jenny will come along and be like, I have Newton Cinnamon. And then, it flows. It actually just, works really well.
It works.
Surprisingly.
Mm-hmm. So I'm assuming both of you have a penchant for wordplay at this point.
Yeah, it's really fun. It's definitely, we try to go for wordplay jokes first because I think they're super fun. Sort of hokey, but fun.
It's the truest form. Humor,
yeah.
Is the pun.
So, if I can ask, in what ways have the evolution of this still very nascent community shaped the way that you guys have developed this series? Like, just the way that our own, My Little Pony fandom has grown and blossomed over the last, less than 2 years.
It definitely helped us decide we should do it.
Yeah.
No one wants to make a video, no one will watch.
Really great.
We've thought in the past, we should do Code Lyoko Bridge. Oh, but wait, no one will watch
it. No one will watch that. We still got Code Lyoko Bridge, episode one, down
up.
The pipeline.
Yeah. Watch for it.
But yeah, so, obviously it's great. And we are obviously huge My Little Pony fans, from way back, season one, episode one. Like, we're,
I liked the old series.
Fans. And Jenny is an old generation fan.
Yeah.
So, the My Little Pony. And the show does not lend itself to be abridged at all.
Yeah, because it's so funny. And that's why you have to do something so weird and different.
It's funny. And the animation's fluid.
Yeah.
And their hair's always jiggling up and down.
Yeah.
And all the other,
abridged
series.
But it's
not
something you can make fun of because it's already clever and good and whimsical. So, you just have to make it different, not like mock it.
Yeah. Can't go the old methods.
Yeah.
So, if you guys are okay with it, we'll go ahead and start with the Q&A.
There's a line. Yay.
There you go.
All right, let's go ahead and get started.
Cool. You'll just have to shout
while we're
them
figuring
at
that
us.
Out, just come up here and ask
it works
the question.
Great at Brony.
Just come up here.
Okay.
That's the question. Actually,
I've got a question.
Okay. All right. Sure.
Uh-oh.
Okay, yep, it's going to give it away. He's going to, shout something angry at us. No.
I just want to say that Rain Cloud is best pony.
So we've had our first confused fan. Rain Cloud is a rain cloud and not a pony.
Now,
so nice try, though.
Not anymore. Now she's dead.
Yeah. She's gone.
I think you guys are I think there's a certain sentient biological organism that would be strongly objecting to that statement.
Yep.
Now she's gone forever.
Yep.
All right. Let's not get too macabre.
Okay.
Yes.
How did the character Sweetie Bot evolve? How did you create?
How did Sweetie Bot
evolve? How did Sweetie Bot evolve?
If I recall correctly, that was a Facebook conversation way back during episode 2. That was, yeah, just after we finished episode 1, we started thinking of episode 2, and we started thinking of what we could do with the other characters, right? We already had ideas for, like, a lot of the characters, and they sort of changed because the actual source footage doesn't match whatever, you know, quirk we were going to give them. Mm-hmm. But
like, we wanted Scootaloo to be, like, a homeless child or a
drug. Like, there's no shots of her in cardboard boxes. So,
Not enough.
But at that time, in the summer of 2011, no one liked Sweetie Belle. It's just, she was the odd one out. She was sort of the boring one, I guess. Like, now, people love Sweetie Belle. But at that time, there wasn't much love for the CMC at all. People hated them. And
Sweetie Belle particularly had no personality yet. She wasn't doing anything.
She was
just
singing,
the third
one. But yeah. So we just thought it would be really funny if she was just a robot. Inexplicably. Inexplicably. And we were never, ever going to even address it. And there was never... Mm-hmm. Even Cheerilee was never going to give a lecture about robot police. She would have just been a robot.
Yeah.
And we would have never addressed the fact that she had a weird synthetic voice. But we ended up making it so it is part of equestrian lore that robots are around and dangerous.
There it is. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm curious, how do you choose which episodes to start with? Because I've seen you jump around and, well, once you choose an episode, well, you be careful because I can no longer watch the Cutie Mark Chronicle. No, not Cutie Mark Chronicle. Call of the Cutie.
Call of the Cutie.
No, it's always... It's always Sweetie Bot.
And what an interesting plot twist, right?
Yeah. Yeah. We usually try for, like, dialogue-oriented episodes. Like, for a while, we thought we would never do Last Roundup because of the chase scene, and we thought, you know, if too much of what's going on is reliant on the things you're physically seeing, it can be hard to change the story of it. And I think now we just go for what characters we want to write for and just write around whatever the action is.
Mostly it has to do with, like, how you can subvert the plot in a big way, right? Like in the sleepover episode, you know, completely different story than the original, right? So that's what made us want to do it because it was so funny. It jumped out of this, like, you know, it could be like a misery situation, like trapped in a house, right?
Yeah.
And then the Dragon Shy episode, we did that one because we thought that we needed to do an episode with every character, like in the...
That's also why we chose Perfect Swarm for the first one, because it had everyone, and it was kind of a weird episode.
But then sometimes it's like, you'll choose an episode because you have a funny, like, basically a funny premise. Like in the last roundup, we had the whole, like, there's a bomb, right? Like, Cherry Jubilee is not nice or whatever, and she's kidnapped Applejack. And so, like, we kind of think of a funny premise like that, and that's, I don't know.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi, I was just wondering if either of you does Diamond Tiara or Silver Spoon.
Yes, I do them both.
Can you do it for us, please?
That is my water.
All right. Sorry, you have to be allowed to do Diamond Tiara. It's like, we're going to have so many snacks there that the Grand Galloping Gala is going to look like the Donner Party. It's going to be like Snack City. That's it.
Thank you.
You should get Jenny to do lines. She can do them all.
Oh, God.
Yes, please do it. First of all, congratulations for drawing a bigger crowd than the musicians did.
Yeah, that's a little...
That's pretty scary.
Of course, the schedule's weird, so I don't think anyone can take credit. If everyone here thought they were watching Smart Cookies right now.
We're not watching Smart Cookies. Smart Cookies?
It's still happening. We're just going to dub the whole thing. Sorry, what's your question? All right.
Again, please do. So, typically, start to finish... Idea, conception to completion. How long does it take you to complete an episode?
I would say it takes from the time the last episode's uploaded to the time the next episode is uploaded.
Yeah. You know, just constant.
We work at a constant rate.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't say that we pour our heart and soul into it every single day.
Yeah, we don't start right away sometimes, yeah, too. It's like a week of like, yay, the episode's out. Let's read comments for just a week. That's all we'll do. And like, you know.
And the comments are never nice.
It's a quote from the episode. Ah, that was a line. Good.
Awesome.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hi. So, in your alternate continuity, mm-hmm, you've got them in the war.
Right.
And then in the actual show, they show up in helmets in a trench. And you have Pinkie Pie being a gypsy. Mm-hmm. And then she shows up in a gypsy costume. Do you ever get the feeling that the writers of the actual show are watching your version?
No.
Or just giving you scenes to use?
I wish that was the case, but probably not, just based
I'm
on timing.
I'm actually Lauren Faust in disguise.
And he would have gotten away with it, too, if it weren't for you pesky bronies.
I didn't have anything to do with season two, though, so really, I don't know why I
revealed
that.
That's true, it's
that
still a coincidence,
well.
Yeah.
I am Lauren Faust, which is not, yeah. I don't know how to answer your question.
Like a lot of guys here, probably, it was the extended version of Pinky's Brew that really drew me into wanting to watch all of it.
Right.
And I think a lot of us are really hoping there's going to be an extended version of Gypsy Bard out there someday soon.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes, there will be.
It's happening.
Thank you. Should I talk a little about Gypsy Bard? I want to talk a little about the Gypsy Bard. Why it's not out, because it was supposed to be out. And there was supposed to be an extended version of Princess of the Night, too, and it just never came to occur. But, wow. Okay. You may have noticed that the sound of the Gypsy Bard is really, really great. And the mixing and the mastering, and the Pinky's Brew is really, really bad. And I heard this Russian version of Pinky's Brew, which I recommend checking out, right?
The Russian cover.
The Russian
by
cover by Leonix or Lenik. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so I friended this guy on Skype. And I said, I love, you know, your cover. I want you to, like, do the Gypsy Bard, and it's amazing. And so I'm just sort of plugging Lennox right here. Like, go check out his stuff. And me and him are going to work on more music, hopefully. Like, even not related to Friendship is Witchcraft, just random stuff. So, cool. Anyway,
yep.
On with your question.
Hi, I would like to ask, how do you come up with the personalities of the characters?
I guess they develop over time. I mean, a lot of them we got right off the bat, like Fluttershy and Twilight, who's one of my favorites.
Yeah, I think it's literally, I think, like, it all has to do with the source footage that we first, like, Fluttershy is, she's shown crushing an apple. So
yeah,
thought,
and she looked mean when she did
and
it.
She
looked
really
angry.
Mean. So we thought, she's mean now.
Yeah.
And then.
And Twilight has kind of, like, big insect eyes. Like, something about the shape and the way they're always pointed makes her look a little out of it
Rainbow
all the time.
Dash, Rainbow Dash.
No, Twilight. Like, she honestly has these big oval eyes that are staring off into space. So she kind of just reminds me of, like, a dumb stuffed animal. So that's kind of, like that. Stuffed Twilight. She looks identical to that in the show. So that's kind of how she evolved, is just, like, a dumb, mean stuffed animal. Like an evil Winnie the Pooh, a little bit.
Well, that's a little harsh. Yeah. All right, thank you.
Thank you. Yay!
Griffin Lewis, I have a question I've been dying to ask you.
I'm scared of this because I know who you are.
It's funny you know who I am because I have no idea who you are. But you want mate.
This is an in-joke and no one's going to get it. But if you're watching right now, I gotta say hi to the Skype call. Hello, Nighty and Poltron and all those guys, and I guess MLPG, hi.
Hello, Giant Skype Group.
Everyone, you know.
Yay.
I get your inside jokes. Now be gone.
No applause for him. Those were the rebels in the audience.
And PHN. Anyway, go on.
Okay. I'd just like to say the music is borderline genius. In parts, from just the lyrics, or especially what I'd like to say is the composition is really great, and I'm curious, do you play each instrument on its own, recorded, and then overlay them over each other, or do you use something like Ableton?
For all the songs, I up till the Gypsy Bard, which was done by Lennox. I don't know how I did it. But up to that point, I just used Logic, and I just used the piano roll. I don't even have a keyboard that can plug into a computer. So I just plug in the notes on the piano roll. But I write all the songs on a piano beforehand. And yeah, I could go on for days about like how they're, like the mentality behind the composition. But you know, as far as the mixing, I'm really bad at it. And I just use Logic and some sounds. Some like, you know, I don't really like, I'm not in love with electronic music. I love like the real sounding instruments. So I use a lot of synthetic instruments, like synthetic flutes and stuff. But none of them sound quite as good as the real thing, right? But, so I don't know if that answered your question.
Yeah, it
did. Thank you.
Great, thank you.
I was just wondering if there was a reason for the difference in like why the color was so bright in episode 7. Why I noticed that, and it's like, hey, this looks different.
Did we get it from a different source? Possibly?
Yeah, it could be. Like, sometimes they have watermarks on the episodes, mm-hmm. and usually you can use the iTunes rip, but then sometimes they're
I mean, buy it from iTunes.
There's sometimes they're, like, it's like
purchase
in the .mkv format, and sometimes my Final Cut doesn't like that. So, maybe it's just the source.
We didn't tweak it ourselves, but it's probably from a different place.
Yeah.
So, okay. So good eye.
He's one smart cookie. Get it?
Oh.
I like that. That's right. Okay, first I just want to say that when I first started watching Friendship Witchcraft, I was like, oh, what is going on? I kept hearing about it on YouTube and everything. And then when I saw Rarity getting into the covers with the bedtime song, that pulled me in. That really just pulled me in. And then I really want to say awesome for your G1 references for Lord Schmooze.
Uh-huh.
Lord Schmooze. And I just want to say... What is your influence on G1? Like, how did G1 kind of bring that about? And are we going to hear any more, maybe more G1 references in the future?
I'm really big on G1 references, and I, like, push for them all the time because I'm a big fan of the old generations, and that's why I'm into Friendship is Magic, because I heard about the show coming because I'd been collecting ponies forever. I was like, this is going to be good. I'm so excited. I didn't know it was going to get, like, a lot of fans, but... yeah, I definitely like to reference back to the old shows, kind of like in this naive hope that old gen fans are also watching, which I don't think is the case. I guess, okay,
that's,
if you like
me.
The old series.
Yeah, I'm a Gen 1
fan
too.
Originally, actually, Twilight's Daydream in the first episode, instead of like a flashback of her false memory with Spike, it was going to just be cut away to the sea ponies.
To the sea ponies.
Yeah, and that not really makes sense. She just had this vision of the sea ponies, and then it cuts back to her gasping, like, we can't let that happen. But yeah, Griffin was like, we showed it to a couple people, and they didn't really get it. They're like, oh, what is this scene? So we cut it, and I think what we ended up going with was funnier anyway, but... I try to push for references and shout-outs to the old show because that's what really got me into ponies.
I think, isn't Princess Sparkle an actual name of a pony?
Yeah, it is. It's one of the princess ponies. Go figure. Yeah.
Cool.
So, lots of shout-outs.
I just want to say one more thing. Hmm? Sweetie Bot is best pony.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm a really good Sweetie Bot, too.
It's
not a pony.
She's a robot.
I don't understand you people.
I got the laptop. Do you wanna...
So which character? It's interesting you mention that because, well.
Let's do this and see if it works.
Testing. Unity Mark Acquisition Program. Hooray! anyone? Like line request.
Yeah, we were going to do, like, line requests, too, because people love
Yeah, people can do line requests.
If anyone has any questions or line requests for best biological organism, then,
or for any of the characters, you know?
Yeah.
I have two questions now. Will you answer my question with the robot voice?
Yes.
And which character is the most fun to make stuff up for, like jokes? Okay.
Do the sweet offer.
Twilight. Sparkle.
Easily.
I like Rainbow Dash a lot, too. I think in recent episodes she's had a lot of good lines. Like, she's just so dumb. And a lot of people are really angry. I guess they all are. No, but a lot of people are angry about the Rainbow Dash one in particular. Like, she's my favorite pony, and the whole joke is just that she's an idiot. But, like, I don't know. She kind of is, so
she
it's
is.
Funny.
Yeah.
A lot of Rainbow Dash haters.
Question is, are we ever going to hear more about Smooze or the Robot Police?
Yes.
Probably.
Smooze,
in some
at least.
Weird way.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, again, we have ideas of how to bring these back, mm-hmm. but we are, you know, not clairvoyant or whatever, right? Like, we can't mm-hmm. see into the future. We don't know what episode is going to be the next one or the next one, right? So when it comes to a big overarching plot, we can't plan anything out. You know, it's just impossible. So Smooze may return if we see an episode and we're like, oh, this will be funny, mm-hmm. this can be Smooze. You know, if you watch season 2 or season 1, you can see some moments where you're like, oh, I could see how this could mm-hmm. be Smooze or something like that. But
yeah, although one funny thing, I don't know if people have thought of it yet, but there is now not going to be another eclipse in the near future, so that's going to be
no
a long
more,
wait for Rarity
no
and Fluttershy for the next eclipse
so
to do the ritual.
And
so.
The yearly solar eclipse isn't going to happen anymore.
Yeah.
So
we'll see. Smooze could be trapped in another dimension now. So. Yeah.
Before anything, is this going live right now?
I don't know.
I'm sure it's. That's a dangerous question.
That is an affirmative.
It wasn't at BronyCon.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see.
All right. Before I even ask this, I guess I should ask if I'm allowed to ask about the Mentally Advanced series.
Sure.
Oh God, there's so much mm-hmm. I can ask about. What do you think about your series, like, compared to their series? What do you think of their series?
We get this a lot, right? They go,
it's a loaded question.
The two series. And
they're very different.
I think they're so different
yeah.
that I don't get when people compare them.
His is sort of more of, like, a parody of the series, where ours is, like, different. So, I mean, yeah, then, I think it's a little pointless
yeah.
to, like, directly
They do some
compare.
Similar things, but I think just the style of humor, it's, like,
yeah.
it's like quick fire, like, rapid dialogue exchanges, which can be really funny, right?
Mm-hmm.
And versus, like, surrealist humor, you know, they're just different.
It's like apples and oranges, so yeah. apple jack oranges. Okay.
Yeah.
Apples and apples.
Yay.
Apples and apples. That's it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm actually wondering what was the inspiration behind Luna's character in the series, because it seems with the references of like her music when she comes in and. The shipping with Yossi, and most notably probably where she's lying in a pile of spaghetti, mm-hmm. that is kind of poking fun at the community a bit. I'm just wondering what was the inspiration for her to develop that way.
I don't know about the pony community, but she's definitely making fun of just like internet culture and like a certain type of
nerd. A
certain
type of person.
Like
yeah.
just sort of a naive, like it wasn't meant to be mean. It's kind of a sweet, innocent nerd that you're meant to feel bad for. She's just
yeah.
so unfortunate, and everyone is so mean to her. And. You
yeah.
know, so I don't think
again,
it was meant to be hateful or anything.
Yeah, and I think we're really inspired for, like, the voice and stuff. There's this video called Taka's Scar, Part 1 and 2.
It's a kid reading his Lion King fan fiction, and he sounds very awkward, and he's got some mysterious European accent.
He's got
accent.
A Bulgarian accent.
So, yeah, Bulgarian.
And
so
so
that was
what
Luna
really
was based
funny.
Roughly on.
So if you find that video, you'll hear, like, this is,
it was
like
oh,
Luna,
it's Luna. I'm hearing
Luna.
Luna
is.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
I wanted to know about the eye candy joke.
Okay.
Everyone does.
Yeah.
yeah. Well, you want to take
well,
it? You've answered it before.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Basically, there's no joke really to get. It's not an inside
okay.
joke or a reference.
Oh, it wasn't. I thought it was a reference.
It's not an inside joke,
no.
surprisingly
okay.
enough.
Mm-hmm.
We like the idea of, like, again, it's a surrealist. It's ultimately like a surrealist comedy, right? So
yeah.
you've got these characters. And they say, talk about eye candy the first time, and it kind of makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
They say, talk about
mm-hmm.
eye candy another time, and it kind of makes sense. But these characters
yeah.
aren't talking to each other.
so you start to go, like, how would she know to say that?
Yeah.
She wasn't there.
Only
like, what
the
universe
viewer,
is this?
Like, only the spectator understands that it's really strange that they said the same phrase, all the ponies, yeah, in different circumstances.
And it gets more warped as it goes, like, you're in the eye candy of the storm. Like, and it's just...
There's
like,
no motivation for her to say that other than, like, a spectator is watching and would be weirded out by this fact.
Yeah. So, no, I've watched this show, I've watched it, like, all the way through multiple times now.
Good.
And every time I watch it, it just... I always wonder, and I notice all of the comments asking. What
yeah,
it
I guess it so. Was too complicated. Like, I think you see that kind of stuff in stuff like Arrested
yeah.
Development. They do show.
Yeah, they have a lot of callbacks
that.
Like that, and you're just supposed to be unnerved by it a little.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
So good. It works. They're unnerved. That's perfect.
All right. I was wondering. There's a number of visual effects in the show.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah.
What comes to my mind is the. Headphones that Luna is wearing
oh,
when
really
she
yeah.
appears. That
yeah.
was really good. I was wondering how you do that effect and whether or not you're...
I did the effects from episodes 1 to 5, and then after that, they were kind of complicated, and I said, oh, I gotta go back to, you know... Or I still was planning on doing them, but it would be painstaking. And
yeah.
one day I was on this like chat room, and this guy named Vrex said he was a huge fan, and he's a Flash animator, and he made those videos of the cars. It's like Fluttershy steals a Trans Am or something like, you know those videos, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, those look really good. He's like, could you do headphones? And then he said, yeah. And then he did the tentacle monster, and he... So I've just got a guy for that.
Yeah, we outsourced it.
Pretty popular guy. Almost more popular than we are.
Have either of you seen some of the fandom elements based off of your show, such as the Sweetie Bot Tumblr Ask Blogger, other such
yeah, we follow that.
Yes.
It's really cute. It's not like show official, but it's
yeah.
really cute and well done.
Any, like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's really awesome. Any fan stuff like that, again, like, we're not part of it, so we don't
yeah.
write it. We can't, it's not part of, like, the canon or whatever you want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, well, like, Sweetie Bot Replies is really fun, and whenever we see people drawing, like, Pinky brewing a cauldron, it's always really awesome. You know?
Yeah.
If you draw fan art, we will reblog it, because, like...
Yeah, we see, like, all of it.
We
so.
Pretty much will see it.
We,
so,
like,
yeah.
Google, you know, in DeviantArt, like, Friendship is Witchcraft, and try to find it all, so there isn't that
first,
much. We'll see it.
During episode 3, it was, like, the first fan art came out. Someone
yeah.
drew... I forget what it was.
I don't remember the first
it
one.
Was, like, oh, it was a Diamond in the Rough thing, and we were, like, this is
yeah.
so awesome. And then now, if you do that on DeviantArt or whatever... You'll just get pages and pages of Sweetie Bot mostly.
Yeah, it's all Sweetie Bot
Sweetie
and
Bot
like Gypsy
Pie, which
yeah.
is awesome, you know. But it's yeah.
So you have an official Tumblr?
We do.
Official Tumblrs.
It's not a Friendship is Witchcraft official. It's
just
our individual ones.
Our Tumblrs.
Yeah. So
we don't like. Yeah, we're not going to plug ourselves.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Perhaps the most important question: who is Best Pony?
Ooh.
like our favorite
yeah
from
our
the,
personal
from
favorite
or
yeah.
from the actual
your
show?
Personal favorite
I like Rarity from Friendship is Magic. I think she's hilarious. Okay, booze. Yeah, I think the voice work on her is really funny, and she's
yes.
just cute looking, and I like it.
And I'm gonna say like Rarity. Yeah, it's the same. It's a boring because we have the same answer every time.
You
yeah,
like
Rarity.
Pinkie Pie.
I do like
Pinkie
Pie too.
Pie.
She's funny.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But they're
yeah.
all the best ponies.
Applejack is also really good. Yeah. Yeah. Boo.
Thank
He's just
you.
Booing no matter what I say.
Friendship is Witchcraft is probably some people's in the room like favorite fandom phenomenon. What
Yay.
Are some of your guys' favorite, you know, like
cool.
entities, alternate universes,
yeah.
whatever?
From the fandom or from
yeah,
anything?
Yeah, you
okay.
know, Moonstock, you know, stuff that's like known entities.
I
don't
know.
Oh, that's tough.
That's tough.
Tumblrs you follow that you really like?
Yeah, I mean
anything.
The
you have time?
we're not so much like part of the like I don't know.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah, we're definitely part of the fandom, but maybe in a different way. Like
I don't read fanfic. I think that's what he means. I don't
no.
really read fanfic.
Don't
we watch
fan
some
fiction.
Fan shows.
I don't know how many fans should like.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Dot Move series, like
I think the Ask the Kingmark Crusaders person
yeah.
is insanely
oh,
good.
That person.
Just everything
right. yeah.
he or she makes
say,
is really good.
Like I love the animation
mm-hmm.
of the
yeah.
Dot Move series. It's so like cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I mean,
yeah, a lot of
and
really
it's
good
cool
visual
that he's
jokes
here, and,
and
you know, and he's got a
yeah,
lot.
Yeah, he's here.
His art style is really really great.
Mm-hmm.
The musicians, you know, I love Replacer is one of my favorite musicians,
mm-hmm.
and
so
it's like yeah, there's
yeah. Mando Pony's
Mando
really
Pony's
good.
Great. Yeah, I'm trying to think
yeah.
of others. I really like Icky. Mm. Icky is here.
Yeah.
Tarby
is good.
Just random
yeah.
names.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah. Name dropping.
Oh,
yeah, thank
and Jay
you.
Carlson, the person who does all the ska
yeah.
covers of our songs.
He's a really good
really,
voice.
Really, really, really great.
Is there any pony in the show that you just can't stand to be in the show?
Twist.
Twist.
Knew it!
Yeah. I think the best thing is Friendship is Witchcraft. Twist is the same, because Twist is like, she's already awful enough that she is a joke.
She fits
like,
right in the universe.
Is there any reasons exactly why?
Twist is
just
the worst?
Like, just a Have gross character. What does she do right? No. Yeah, just, she's kind of like gross-looking character design and like a voice that grates on your ears.
I mean, she's not quite as bad as
Bad
Spike,
personality. No.
I'm kidding, though. No.
Even Applebloom didn't want to stick around and be her friend. Yeah. So...
All right,
I'm sorry if she's your favorite. It looks like you're becoming crushed like right now.
Looks like you're a Twist fan, man.
Twist fans.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
What is the best reaction that you've gotten from family or friends?
There was a video of, like, I want to say it was in, like, Sweden or something. Someone had videoed a pony meet where everyone was just, like, you know, off-key singing, like, Pinky's Brew. And that was really weird because you see people do that with winter wrap-ups. So you're like, this is what it feels like. So, like, that was cool. I mean, it's kind of a brony staple is, like, the off-key group singing that's just really fun and powwow-ish. So, yeah, I thought that was cool.
I have two kind of pony stories. Well, one is that, like, so I have an older and younger brother, right? And my older brother was always like, "Ah, oh, this pony show is stupid." Like, he thought it was like a big joke where we just make fun of the show.
And now you're famous.
Right. Well, yeah. But anyway. But like, he was like, "Oh, that's so stupid." And we were doing the Friendship of Witchcraft, and he was like, "Oh, you know, he didn't want to watch it. And he finally watched it, and he loved it. And I think the greatest thing was I was just like on the computer. He's in the other room. And he just starts, like, cracking up. He's like, appling hook. Like, Applejack's gadget in episode 3 was the appling hook.
In her action profile.
He thinks that's the funniest joke for some reason. My other story isn't quite related to Friendship is Witchcraft, but it is related to Friendship is Magic, and I think it's really, really funny, is that we have a friend. And he's a closeted brony, right? He's clearly in the stable.
We can say his name live right now.
obviously I'll use very code words, but funniest thing is, so he's part of the
sweating.
He's part of the Air Force
somewhere.
Academy, right? So doing that, you know, obviously you got a reputation, you can't say stuff like that. But he comes home and he's, you know, really like into the brony stuff, but he's obviously embarrassed about it. He doesn't want anyone to know he's a brony. So we're driving along or whatever, and he says the phrase 20% cooler. And then, you know, me and my other friend, Chase, we just snap around. We're like, you said 20% cooler. You watched the show. And he's like, no. And then we were like, but you said 20% cooler. You said that thing needs to be 20% cooler. That's the exact line. It's like, 20% cooler is military slang.
He has a Reddit posting exclusively
and
in the pony
like,
section.
He wears the new Lunar Republic T-shirt. Around, like, what's that T-shirt? And he's like, it's an inside joke. You wouldn't get it. And it's like,
oh, this question's for Jenny, because I know in one of your interviews you said that when you were voicing certain characters, you know, you tried like one line to get in character.
Yeah.
Like, you know, use like Twilight Sparkles Balloon for Applejack or something like that. Yeah, what other lines do you use for all the other characters? Especially Luna's.
For Luna's, it's like a room reference. For Luna's, I go, oh, hi, Twilight Sparkle. And then it's like, so that's Luna. Spike, it's him, like, whining, like, Twilight. that's pretty much half of his lines anyway, so you just do that. And Twilight is her Celestia letter. It's Dear Princess Celestia. And, yeah, Applejack is, it's Twilight Sparkles Balloon. And I can't think of the others.
It's
I have a
Rainbow
lot.
Dash is
Rainbow Dash is just, whoa. And Applebloom is, it's not fair. It's just not fair. And
it's Rarity, right?
Oh, and Rarity's, oh, Twilight Sparkle. So you have to do the sassy hand. It's part of it. but yeah, so that's about it. That's all I can think of. I may have missed one. Oh, and Fluttershy is, oh, okay. So, yeah. Thank you.
Are there any lines from the show that just stick with you guys and you find yourself saying that in character? If you could say it for us.
I think there's definitely some lines that we really, really like.
Yeah.
I don't think they're always the same lines that the fans really like.
One of my favorites is the Dear Princess Celestia, you've got to check out this ball.
Check this ball out.
Do you think spiders can dream? Another spider related thing, one of my favorite things I love in episode 6 is when they said, oh god, they tipped over the bowl, the spiders are escaping, right?
Yeah.
Like, I love this idea that there's a bowl of killer spiders.
It's like containing
and it's
them
just
somehow.
Precariously just in the middle of the town. And if it gets knocked over, spiders will start attacking people.
You think about that. Yeah.
Stay away from that bowl. It's dangerous. I really like just Spike, like, I'm too dumb and fat. It's one of my favorites.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Yeah. Feel free to ask a question.
Yeah. There's no one left. That's it. Panel over.
I noticed you guys hide a lot of fun little quotes in like group scenes, background characters whispering stuff.
Uh-huh.
Any good ones we might have missed or just memorable ones? Because I'm sure I've missed a bunch myself.
Cheerilee's whole monologue in episode 4 is really funny.
It's just a hilarious monologue about her ex-husband. It's really funny. I don't think it's been uploaded fully anywhere. But it's
we should
great.
Do that, like on Tumblr or something.
One of our favorite characters, I think, is just. Carrot Pony. It's really idiotic.
And Brony Mike does a lot of really funny lines in the background, like that. I just follow the crowd, like in his really crazy voice that no one can duplicate. So,
I think
there are about 900 people watching on the live stream right now. We have a question from the live stream.
Okay.
They want to know. They want to know, when is Discord coming to Friendship is Witchcraft?
Okay, so.
Possibly next episode.
Yeah, we'll see. So, what's weird, because we decided for fun we would do sort of mix it up and do these shorts, right? The shorts are taking some time. This one was a mess. But we still hope, we're going to fix it up and upload it soon. But we have another short that's going to come out in quick succession and probably another one. And the next short does have...
It's part of that episode.
It's part of the Discord episode.
So, and we also want to do some villain-oriented... jokes.
We want to have some villains involved, and we're trying to think of how to do that without, again, it's so hard because it's like, we really want to do this, but there's no clips from the show of the, all the villains forming a Legion of Doom, and so we could do some really complex animation or something like that, but I honestly don't know when Discord's going to come.
Thank you.
But soon, we want to do it. We have some ideas. Thank you, live stream. Look, the camera's there.
I have a question. I've noticed, and I sort of mentioned this, but the show is fairly clean for internet standards, and especially from what I haven't seen many other Abridged series, but from what I've heard, it's cleaner than most. I'm curious, what inspires that? And I really appreciate it, because especially to keep it inside of the Friendship is Magic kind of world, it's nice.
Yeah, I guess we just try for really nice sound and editing.
We don't like dirty jokes. We don't
I thought he meant quality for some reason. We like to keep
it
PG. I feel like ponies cussing is such an obvious joke. And I know that also, ponies is something a kid is more likely to see. And it's something that I know the show creators object to seeing anything too dirty. And, I'm not trying to slam people that do those jokes because I've seen a lot of really funny ones like that. But we try to keep it clean.
That kind of brings me to a question I was wanting to ask for this panel. What is your guys' opinion and reaction to the fact that people from DHX Media have actually watched your series in its entirety and enjoyed it thoroughly?
That's awesome.
That's really mind blowing.
Yeah, I know.
And obviously, really strange.
I can't believe that.
And
I'll take your word for it.
I think Daniel Ingram commented on the. Art of the
Mattress. Art of the Mattress,
song,
the GRU upload of it.
So, I don't know how to respond to that kind of question. Like, obviously, it's amazing.
Yeah, it's really, really cool.
Great
it's
feeling.
Like crazy that people are seeing it online. Yeah, so it's great.
I'm glad they enjoyed it, and I hope they are aware of who we are.
Hello.
Hello.
So, my question is to Griffin, and I know that you're an aspiring musician, and I just wanted to know how long you've been playing instruments, and I wanted to know what instruments you do play.
I play one instrument, the piano, and I don't play it that well. I took music lesson, piano lessons when I was very young, and my piano teacher quit because I was not improving in my skill level. Like, it had been a year, and she said I still couldn't play the do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. So she just quit, and we still had we had a piano lying in her house for a long, long time.
And then, do you two collaborate on the songs that you write, or is it just you?
I do the lyrics, and then he does the entire, like, tune and whatever.
It's hard for two people, I think, to collaborate.
Yeah, and
on,
I'm
like,
not
that,
tune, you know, like I like music. I'm not that good at creating it, so.
Yeah, but I'm basically more or less, like, self-taught, and I just, you know, got into a mode of songwriting. You know, I'm more interested in songwriting than learning to play songs, and it's a little weird because people are like, oh, you know, you're this guy. I'm sure you can play a lot of songs on the piano because you can play Pinky's Brew and stuff. It's like, I can only play Pinky's Brew. I can't play anything else. But I'm always writing songs. I have like 100 little songs that I've written, and you know, I'm going to try to do something with them at some point in time.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Rarity hat. Cool.
What's your favorite part about making the show? Like the music, the jokes, or like whatever?
That's tough.
I think the joke. I mean, I think the jokes
writing
are
the
really,
jokes
really
probably.
Fun. And the problem is sometimes we have so many joke ideas. Well, in our script, we'll write out the joke. You know, maybe one of us comes up with a joke.
And we put like a double slash, and then more jokes.
Do a double slash. Like, this could be the line, or it could be this.
And it gets kind of complicated.
And
sometimes.
Oftentimes we record them all.
Yeah.
Because we
and then just cut them. Yeah.
We're not sure if they'll match the lip sync properly.
Yeah. So we did that unreleased lines, like line alternatives video. That was just a huge collection of all the stuff we had cut. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I really think that my favorite joke in the show is Carrot Top and everything she has to say.
Yeah.
And I'm really curious about what's behind that and any inspiration that might have gone into that, because I think the voice is hilarious.
I think it literally started with Carrot Top was in the first episode. Again,
with the silly voice.
And she, in the episode, she says, like, you know, like
we couldn't fit it all in. Just like all cute sounding.
So we thought it would be funny and do the background characters and the... that we would have just like a male voice, and it would be really as stupid as possible.
Yeah.
And then weirdly, like, we didn't think that would be a big thing. And then like
she keeps popping up.
Carrot Pony is in like all the other episodes.
Yeah.
So we call her Carrot Pony too. We don't call her Carrot Top.
Yeah. it's a comedian's name. Carrot Pony is just funnier and cuter.
Carrot Pony. There's nothing really to it. Just this is the dumbest voice.
So she just says things to reflect her dumb voice. Do the
parties are for
yeah.
Carrot Pony, parties are for grown-ups too.
Thank you.
Pushing hay is really hard.
Hi, so first of all, I have to say, I absolutely love Friendship is Witchcraft. It's brilliant.
Thank you.
So in it, I noticed you have, like, the robot police, fashion police, magic police, and candy police. Why so many police? And what other ones are we going to see?
It's a military state.
Do you not like justice?
It's important. They need to keep everything in line.
Do you think crime sleeps?
Someone's got to regulate that stuff. So.
Okay. Oh, and will we be seeing more giant hats?
I think if we ever do the episode with the...
Sweet and Elite.
The Sweet and Elite
which
episode.
Which we probably
will
do
already written itself.
It's such a perfect episode to
it'll
do.
It'll just be the word giant hat, this whole, every line.
That's the whole script. Episode. Yeah. Just in increasingly snooty voices. So, really good.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, hi, guys. So my question is, has there ever been any talk about maybe collaborating with another person, maybe like Fin Flam Philosophy? Like doing one worlds collide kind of thing, maybe?
I don't think
you guys together.
Probably
I don't think I don't think we'll ever collaborate with anyone
on
that level, like a cross series kind of thing. I don't
just
think
because
so.
When series have different styles, sometimes combining it doesn't make it funnier. It just makes each different
stranger.
Half work less.
Yeah.
So.
So I mean, sometimes we'll ask people like, "Hey, do you want to be part of our, like, you want to join our little team?"
Yeah, we like getting guest voices and just like
guest
people we know, like, "Hey,
fun.
Come on in, do a voice." Yeah.
You know, again, it's one of those things where like, we're just trying to have fun. And we're just making, you know, the second it stops becoming fun, we'll just stop doing it, right?
Yeah.
Because we're not doing
sorry.
It out of an obligation to anyone, right? We're just trying to have fun.
Right.
And, you know, it'd be great to, like, collaborate with some people if it were fun, right? But if we're ultimately, like, if we want to collaborate with someone, we want someone to do a line, we'll just ask a friend. Because that friend
it's
really,
faster,
would really
yeah.
love to do a line for the thing, you know. and they've never been in, you know, it's just, it's, I think, a better solution.
Yeah, we try to, like, do casting videos, too. Not be totally unfair, but it depends on time crunches, too. So, but yeah, we do like working with other people. It's just, you know, you network sometimes and try to find people.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, thank you. I just want to let all you guys know that we're about out of time, so just we're going to take questions from who's up right now and probably wrap it up.
And I think we should do line requests because I know people love line requests.
Yeah. We've got time for that. Definitely have time for that.
Two more questions.
All right. I was going to say, I know that everyone knows about Lord Schmooze and how he's been an ongoing joke in the show. Mm-hmm. And I was just wondering, he died out in the last episode, like you didn't have him included with the Fluttershy bit. Mm-hmm. And I was wondering if he was just a joke that had been overused and was dying out, or if he is going to have a return to the series.
Okay. He might return if the footage calls for it. It is Schmooze, though. Everyone says Schmooze.
Not Schmooze. You're talking about Fluttershy's tentacle monster that came out of the house?
Just in general, the Schmooze idea and Fluttershy together.
Again, we don't even make it clear that Schmooze is real.
Could be lying to everyone.
Fluttershy is like L. Ron Hubbard, right? It's kind of like she's this. I'm not trying to burden anyone. I'm just saying she's this sort of weird cult leader. The thing she's saying could be true, or she could have just made it up to manipulate people.
Yeah, like, or she could believe it, and it could still not be true. So
clearly, in episode 6, she's trying to bake a portal because you know, if Gypsy can do it, then so can she. You know, she doesn't like Pinkie Pie.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And we don't know the purpose of the portal.
But, like, she failed, you know. She, you know, Pinky used low-quality ingredients for her portal, and the family, the parents are coming back, all strange.
Young and
now Fluttershy, he probably used, like, the Russian translation of the song. And you've got the tentacle monster that came out. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're not, no one is good at witchcraft. The spells aren't working.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, this last question is actually another question from our live stream viewers.
Yay.
Wave to the live stream because they all can see you right now. There we
it's
go.
Like the Muppets, everyone. All right.
And this question is they would like to know, what are your comedic influences? Because a lot of people have pointed out that a lot of your humor seems to be rather British at times.
I would say I really like.
That's what they're saying. I'm just passing the message along.
I think Arrested Development.
Arrested Development.
That's one of our biggest influences.
Yeah. And we like British humor in the sense of, like, all the Ricky Gervais series are really funny.
Gervais is funny.
But I don't think it would count as an influence because it is such a different type of humor. Like, it's more dry. We're more, like, just campy and kind of dumb.
It's weird. Yeah. I think, like, I love, you know, I love Sheep in the Big City. That's a show that just loves to make puns. The whole show, it's just... Every pun, you can tell they were really proud of it when they came up with it, and they're just throughout the whole thing. And I sort of like that because it's so innocent to make these little stupid puns that just make you cringe. But yeah, mostly I don't even watch that much. Like, we don't watch other Abridged series that much, I don't think.
I've seen the Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged series, which was really funny. But I don't think we're trying to make ours like any of the successful ones. Like, I think it's just more our own thing. So.
Oh, I didn't say abridged. I said British.
Yeah, British. I know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I wouldn't say ours is like a British style of humor, although I do think that kind of humor is really funny. Okay. So, yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Livestream. Cool. Okay.
So
are we out of time?
We're almost out of time. We're just going to take a couple really quick line requests because we know that's what you guys are waiting for. So just pop up a hoof if you want to.
Say anything.
Yes. Have say.
Sin, speak,
race. Oh, my God.
Yep.
Non-singing request.
No singing.
Anyone.
Amanda.
So
you
pick someone.
Face.
Yeah. You want to pick people?
Jenny do Twilight reading a newspaper.
Okay. I did that for like a live stream. Yeah. Ooh, ah, this is a great newspaper. Twilight's reaction noises are my favorite. Okay, standing up. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, aren't you looking as cute as a wheelbarrow? Okay, and I'll do it. Is it still on?
Is that right?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Set phasers to hug.
Okay. I don't know who to pick. How about Sweetie Belle Rockstar? Okay. Well, Princess of the Night have extended.
Yeah.
We had one in progress. It's on indefinite hold now,
it's on indefinite hold.
So maybe it'll be fun.
I think if you look through my Tumblr, you can find like a 6 minute.
Yeah, like an extended instrumental.
It was gonna be like 6 minutes long. It was gonna be long. But it's basically on indefinite hiatus. Yeah. So.
Now we've got Gypsy Bard. You picked
you in the yellow shirt here.
What is it? Oh, okay. I didn't learn anything. Okay.
Oh, man.
Huh? Oh, who's that pretty lady? Okay. In the front? Oh, okay. I always liked rainbows and all. Oh, I don't even remember the whole line.
How was it?
Oh, my God.
It's two words.
No, rainbow, okay, anyways. And rainbow, dash, rainbow, dash, rainbow, rain, dash, dash. Okay, it was two guys, words.
Guys, we're, unfortunately, we're about out of time
we're
here.
We're out of time, but just come find us. We'll walk here on
I want to say a very
yeah,
warm thank you
over there.
To Sureclaw Phones. Thank you so much for coming to Everfree Northwest.
Yay!
Tell everyone thought they were going to watch Smart Cookie.